Hi everyone, Roger here from Ask the Car Experts YouTube channel, and today I want to go over something very important called an oil priming procedure. Now you want to prime your engine anytime you're interrupting the oil circuit. I just did an oil filter housing on this. I'm going to want to prime the engine. If I drop the pan, I'm going to want to prime the engine. If I replace the turbocharger, probably still be a good idea to prime the engine. And I replace the oil volume control valve, and that definitely will interrupt the oil circuit. And I want to prime the engine. So let me go over the BMW correct steps to perform an engine oil priming. Please remember to take a second and like and subscribe to Ask the Car Experts YouTube channel. Now the first step is to rotate the engine by hand two times clockwise only. So I'm going to go ahead and rotate the engine at least two times, always clockwise. If you go counterclockwise, you can damage your engine. And this is going to cause the oil pickup to mechanically draw up some of that oil and to start priming the system. All right, I did at least two times. I actually did a lot more than I did, about 10 times, because I did have a lot of stuff apart and I just wanted to make sure I primed everything very, very good. Now you're also going to do this if you're going to replace an engine. Again, anything interrupting the oil circuit. So the next step is you could disconnect all of your injectors and all of your coils, because we don't want to have spark and fuel going in when we're rotating the engine. We just want the starter to mechanically draw up the oil and help prime everything to prevent any kind of damage. Now there's a trick you can do on the N55 all the way in the back here. It's kind of hard to show you this, but the engine computer on N55 is back here under the intake manifold. The very last connector right here, there's a slider, and I slid it back. This is my injection and spark harness that goes to the DME. The DME is right there, so that's the very last connector all the way towards the bulkhead. I have that disconnected, and now I can go ahead and crank the engine over without firing off my coils or my spark plugs. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and power this on. And it shouldn't start on me because I do have the injection harness unplugged. And the steps are to crank the engine for 10 seconds, rest for 20 seconds, and then repeat two more times. So we're gonna go 10 seconds and shut it off. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I'm gonna rest for 20 seconds. All right, now another 10 seconds of cranking. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Of course, you are gonna get a malfunction. And now my third time for 10 seconds after waiting 20 seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now that that's done, I'm gonna go ahead and reconnect the connection on the DME. And I'm gonna go ahead and install my electric fan and then fire her up. Now I'm gonna have to clear the codes, and hopefully we don't have any vanos codes that set. Sometimes air can still get into the vanos system and the solenoids do hold some of that air. So you actually have to take the car out onto a steep hill if you can. Stop, clear the codes, and then start the car and gun it. And you actually want to throttle really hard, beat the car up almost, which is going to force that oil through the vanos system. You might get the check engine light again, which is going to shut things down. You actually have to repeat, and you might have to do that a few times if you still have air in the vanos system. Sometimes it takes a few times to get that air out. And we have to put the fan in, which drops straight down. Just make sure nothing gets caught that we've already removed. These are our AC lines, and that hose kind of gets in your way. You have to push it out to get this down. Don't forget to pop that little arm off that we slid over. Slide that back over, lock it in place. And we have this rubber piece right here that's going to go onto this charge air pipe right here. And once everything's lined up, we just have to push it into place straight down. I'm going to throw a little bit of lube on that rubber coupling right there. You see right here, glass cleaner worked really well and actually just slid into place. And then I have the two tabs right here. On the bottom, there's two small tabs. So just keep it close to the radiator as you slide it down, and it should lock in to those bottom pieces. So this is all set now. Let's go ahead and plug in my electrical connection and button up the top end here. Now, if you remember, we took these clips off to make it a little bit easier. These are just going to slide into place, and actually they want to grab that line already, right? Because these lock right into those. And then I have one more, which goes over here. Slide that into place. And then our upper goes in that one. And our lower locks into the other one. Then we have our reinforcement bar. If you remember, we needed to slide it under the AC line here, come up past, so that we don't break this line right here. And this is our cable for our hood latch. That has to hook onto these outside tabs right here. Slide that back into place. We just have the four bolts to install, and this is going to rest here and lock on so it doesn't get into the fan or get into the belt or anything. Always a good idea just to take a look at everything, make sure everything looks good. Just have to put the air snorkel on and go ahead and fire it up, clear the codes, and take her for a test drive. Well, there we go, she's purring away. Hope you guys enjoyed that. That was the belt failure with a front main seal. I did end up replacing the valve cover, which I have a video on. I'll put a link up in the corner for the full video on an N55 oil filter housing. I already have a video on the oil filter housing on the N55, so if you're interested in that, I'll put a link also somewhere or in the description. And she's purring away, so hopefully my buddy gets another long run with his BMW X5 E70 with an N55. It's got over 100,000, and hopefully we can hit 200,000. Thanks for watching, everyone. Please remember to like and subscribe.